Okay, I'll be recording a little bit of gameplay on Star Wars The Old Republic. Just for a little bit, I just wanted to play just a little bit. I have two characters, one in this server and then the other one in another server. The other one is a Force user, this one's a Bounty Hunter. And even though the audio quality on the microphone is kind of terrible at the moment, I haven't found a workaround to kind of fix that. I tried OBS to record this, but the frame rate is not that good. So I'll go and use Windows or the Xbox game bar for this one. What I'll do is probably just mute the microphone ever so often. And that's pretty much it. It's not as effective as, or the noise reduction is not as effective on this equalizer application and using RNN noise. For some reason it's not as effective. It still picks up the noise from the keyboard and mouse. So probably just do one quest, or these quests right here, the generator and the peblock. And I think that's pretty much it. I don't have access to the speeder yet, I think. Yes. This one requires piloting, and I don't have that. So occasionally, when I press the keyboard, or press anything on the keyboard, you'll obviously hear the noise. But if I use OBS to record certain gameplays, it usually works a little bit better. There was also one that I've tried to reduce noise, which was crisp.ai, I think. That one's very effective in noise cancellation or noise reduction. The difference with that one is the application needs to hear the noise first before adjusting its noise reduction. So I've added another quest. I think I'll go with this one. This quest, just like a quick, maybe a couple of minutes. I kind of wanted to get into another MMO and I chose this one. I played it a little bit from like maybe a few years back. Maybe it's not really something, I don't really get into MMOs as much. Only usually play a little bit if I get really into it. And for this one, I think I only have like something of deluxe something or whatever that is. Whatever it gets activated, I'm not quite sure. But I think I did that for this one. Or I'm not quite sure, I don't quite remember, but all I remember is I did something, or I purchased something in this game, and to unlock certain features. And this game is actually subscription based, and either way you can still play regardless. Or anyone can still play regardless. What's this? Oh, is this one too far away? Too far away, out of range. I had to actually platform up here to get to this console, maybe? Oh, it's a hidden stash. Well, not so hidden. But overall, I think this game is fun. As an MMO. And also in regards to the story, it's quite good. Mission, is that one a mission item or is just I can't pick it up? Can't pick it up, I think. No, I cannot. Might as well find a way to sell some of these items. I can't really use these items anymore. These ones, even though they're good cosmetically, or they're good or okay cosmetically, but I need to find a way to sell some of these. I hope you had. Oh, I actually get this. So I might as well remove some of this. The experimental one. I can't really sell it. It's not gonna give me credits or anything. So I might as well get rid of the experimental one. There's other ones in here that came through in the mail. Or the game, in-game mail. It is. I get a new bracer. Streak bracer. Okay. Then, moving on to the next quest. Well, with this one, I can't really hear the fan as much. So that one's a kind of like a good change. Using the RN noise reduction. It's just that I have to kind of press kind of softly on the keyboard as much as I can in order for it to not make any noise. And what is this? This could be a quest. Droid pieces. Now I think I can. Maybe I can summon these. Yes. These don't do anything. They're just there with you all the time. These ones I got through the mail also. You get them after the certain game releases. It's a Star Wars game that's like released also. You get these ones. Well, you don't necessarily have to purchase the game. You just get those items. Just because, you know.
You must be Pebble.
It's released. Level 9. Same with the other character that I have, which is level 9. Which I'm kind of having trouble with. I'm having trouble. Oh, these ones are cost a lot of credits. Well, that one specific item did. This one increases mastery for a couple of or 60 minutes. That one's good. This one increases XP. That one cost quite a bit. Now, as much as I can. Now I can expand as soon as I got enough credits. I think I did that with the other character. But for these ones, look at this. It even cost me money for just selling this item. Zero credits to sell. And I can't find a stash or anything that I could use. So I'll just work with that. I might as well use this stim pack, which is 1 hour. with this one, I'm not quite sure. I think I have one already that's for 1 hour. I'll take this quest.
What's your game plan? Nemo considers smuggler useful. Rescue preferred. If mission objective, use this device. Deactivate smuggler alternate objective.
So the conversations in this game is quite interesting, and it's quite good, actually. You have certain choices at some point to choose the good side or the bad side, and which shows on your character your alignment after you've selected a choice on certain quests. And the choices can either align with the dark side or the light.
Yeah. What'd you
hear? And that also somewhat determine, I think that one also determines your role in the game, I think. Or it helps the game determine the specific quests that you'll be able to take at some point in the game, that's heavily dependent on your alignment. Now, in terms of the story of the game, I'm not quite sure where it actually is. I'm not quite sure. I think I saw Darth Vader at some point, or the one that doesn't have the mask anymore, or something like that. I'm not quite sure which part of the story this one is in, but in the intro you can see Darth Vader. And that's pretty much all I know at this point. And I really wanted to use OBS to record this one because it has better, because of the better noise reduction. And the speaker, or the microphone that I have, is a Razer Siren, and it doesn't come with noise reduction. The newer one, I believe, comes with the Razer Synapse that gives it a little bit more noise reduction, or has complete working noise reduction. And then I can take another quest up there. I usually take all the quests because it also gives me an achievement doing so in Steam and in game, I think. And there's also stuff like that, just like in World of Warcraft. Also in World of Warcraft, I only have like a certain amount of characters, maybe up to level 19 12, something around that range, like level 18, something like that. Really want this to go down, please. There it is. Somewhere here. I have to use this panel.
Who are you? Not Vathra's people, I know that. Kray sent you, didn't he? How you planning to bust me out?
I can't stroll around with this slave collar up.
Okay, I want to change the settings a little bit. And also increase the volume a little bit more. That one's just centered on the volume. This one's much louder.
I'm not bothering. Are you planning to bust me up if I step? Craig, you did.
Hopefully,
I got you. All.
There it is. Here are the two choices that you can pretty much do that affect your overall character in the game. So for this one, I'll choose the light side for this specific character. And for possibly a different character, I'll choose the dark side. And then I think I have my first character somewhat in between, but mostly in the dark side at this point. So deactivate enslaved miner shock coins. So I have to do this. I think there was one down there, but I think there should be enough for to finish this quest. I kind of wish that I maybe find the DLL for the noise reduction on OBS, which is better than this updated version for some reason. Or it works a little bit better. So I could probably maybe mess around with the OBS files and try to find the DLL. I think I found the DLL at some point, but it's not compatible with the which one was it? The equalizer application. Let's go with this.
You did it! By the time I'll run ahead.
That quest says right there, return to Craig. Alright. What is this? Oh, it's just a passageway. It's not actually a quest. It just says that you can go. Thank you. the other one that's not even my level yet. I get a... what's this? Advancement? What is that? What does that do? Not bitter combat style. No, that's... combat style. Summon a random pet. I already have both summoned. Quest and merges for transport to the fleet location where vendors and trainers of all kind can be found. I think I did this one in one of my characters, I think. I'm not quite sure. There's a new spell and passives, and there's also this one. If I were to be subscribed, what's this? Oh, it pops up on Steam.
Any word from the wife?
Yeah.
The Steam UI is in.
Arthur was taking over the rest yards. She used
showing up. Introduction to Conquests. Finish a conquest. I'm not quite sure what that is. Pretty much says I should. Now, to free up space, I can probably use this as an outfit. The covert pilot. So. The outfitter right here. Just equip all of those. Usually only cost that 350 to wear this one, which is quite cool. What is this one? Unify. Chest. Oh, it probably tries to match up the colors, maybe. I think so. I think that's what it does. It doesn't show a dark side corruption or anything like that, but yeah, pretty much this one, which is fully covered. And it doesn't give you this. It doesn't give you the stats. You're just wearing the this outfit. What is this? I have two star drives now following me. What? Okay. That could be a glitch or something. This one purges incapacitating and movement impairing effects. Not aggro as much as I can. I just wanna finish this one and then maybe go to the other characters. Maybe just showing the other characters. way it should be. I think it should be faster. And then speed up for a little bit. Strongholds, which one was that? The conquest option. I don't know. I'll probably try that at some point. This one, these conquests. Oh, I see. So I finished one. Complete a conquest, it says. Oh, this entire thing. Oh. This whole thing, this whole objective over here is a conquest. Or I just have to fill this up to 100,000 and it counts as a conquest, I think. Time remaining 1 day. Nope, I do not think I'll reach that within that time. Or that time limit. And otherwise, I'm not playing this game for that much. Anyway, maybe eventually. But I just wanted to get into this game with a different character, just by a little bit more. Some items, or probably use this stim pack over here just to free up space.
No.
Yolt.
Oh, and I was so
calm down.
Thank you. You don't have to kill Runivathra's.
I can either kill Yolt or make a deal with him. It really only helps you. Okay.
Works for me.
No prop there. It's done. Bothra just lost.
And yeah.
Get out of here.
Thank
you. I'm just curious of what this one does. Like completely choosing the light side. Most of these encounters. I can just drop off over here. It does this parkour roll thing. Yes, he has a neat companion. So I'm guessing with this guy, he already has a bunch of achievements already done. I've seen him before at some point. Going the same way, kind of. Oh. with you where the S-meters are. Just over here.
State your destination. All vehicles leave on time. There are others waiting. Move along.
Towards the marketplace. So after this one, talking to Nemuro the Hutt, I will be logging out and might be end up showing the other character for a little bit. Just showing where which server it is. So there's two servers for North America. I think the other one is called Star Forger. And this one I don't quite remember what it was, what it's called. It doesn't really show me anywhere. But this one's a different server for North America. So the other character is basically just in the other server. And you can also transfer characters in this game. Obviously, should be probably a requirement for an MMO. I might as well sell some of these. Sell junk. Okay, that one's a little bit faster. I don't really need that one as much. And I think I should be good. And one thing that I noticed, I think there is durability. So there is kind of like a need to repair some stuff.
Hello yourself.
I suppose, no reason to get crazy. You and I are catching up here.
You wanna tell me?
Ukai, te kalia shrekula waska kwa pokta nuta. Londikava trita ni.
You're gonna jump.
Say it too, big.
I suggest.
Shmila wa.
Oh. Okay. He's going to attack me either way. Okay. Judas. Look at that. What they call that race again, or whichever one in Star Wars. Or a species, or alien species. Sponsor me, name it, I'll kill it. Right back at you.
I'll have a little
Alright. It's this one. Okay. And also I have this. Which is the same animation as this one. I think it's the same animation. Or almost exactly the same animation. Possibly, maybe. I just have to probably time it right. Something like that. Basically that. Okay. I get to talk to Judah.
just get more and more impressive.
Okay.
Good to see you again.
I was thinking the same thing. Here you go. Credits for the accountant. Poor little Yalt, this bossy wife. See you soon, bounty hunter.
Okay. Another item box for credits, which I can probably eventually use to expand the inventory. Hey, look, what is this? House cleaning. I'll get to that one soon enough. But I want to expand the inventory slot to that. That is quite a lot. That is a decent amount for inventory space. That is very decent, actually. So this one stacks, I think, so it should be good. Okay, that should be enough. That's like 30 minutes of gameplay. But it's not completely the entire gameplay through one level 1 to 10, but that should be enough for this one. Might as well take a seat or something, somewhere, or lie down somewhere, maybe? Where can I do that? Well, I can't lounge over there. Just get so over here. Maybe I can do a sitting animation. This one, right side, guess so. Maybe. Yeah, that's okay. There's even two people fighting over there. Oops, wanna do that. Alright, now how do I, leave. Oh, here it is. Log out. So I just want to show the other character for a little bit. On the other server. Go to server selection. This one. Here it is. Satel Sean for the bounty hunter character. And then I have the other Sith character. Starboard. This one, a sorcerer. Then if I press on create character, I'm not gonna create this character, but I'm just gonna, you can choose whichever allegiance you want. Usually I go with the Sith Empire. The other bounty hunter that I chose was a commando. That's a big machine, or large machine. There's also a sniper, power tech. Power tech, I think, which it was what Boba Fett had, I think. That's a jetpack. So I'm not quite sure if this one has a jetpack or not. So this one, same with the Imperial Agent. I think these ones are the important ones. These ones are technically subclasses. You choose that, and then you can customize your character and choose between three species. There's also other species over here that you can choose, but they're locked. I think they're unlocked once you probably subscribed or something like that. Maybe.
Just point me in the direction of the action.
I'm always a professional.
Also, the customization is free. So yeah, that's pretty much it for that one. The character creation. I think that's pretty much it. Let me see here if I can see the can you show or see or show you the here it is, the cinematic. So there's a bunch here. I think this one was like the first cinematic for
Republic
the game.
Republic is the galaxy's only hope for peace and justice.
Way back in 2011, maybe. I think. Or
the Sith Empire exterminates everything in its path.
2011 or something, or probably even way back.
The enemy has no remorse for the worlds it destroys. Everything we value will die unless we hold the line. This war isn't about politics or.
So yeah. Deceived. I think this one is like after that.
Revenge.
So let's see here. Let me find the one that has like Darth Vader in it. I think could be this one. Disorder maybe. I can't see Disorder. Trade maybe. No. I can't find it. But it basically had like a cinematic when I started the game or something like that. I'm not sure if it's Darth Vader or maybe probably even someone else. I don't know. Don't really know much about this game. But for this one, they have very interesting looking armors. This one kind of got me into playing this game. This cinematic right here. I just saw it like once. Probably got me interested, quite interested. But this one, this cinematic over here got me into playing this game actually. Because of the interesting armor set. Same with this
one.
Or probably this one. Probably this cinematic. Whichever one that had like that interesting looking armor set. I think that's pretty much it. 44 minutes of gameplay. Yeah. Star Wars Lord of the Rings. Legendary status is by completing the origin stories for this one. So that person that we saw a while ago that was playing a bounty hunter already completed these quest lines. Which probably took days and days, probably even months of playing the game. So yeah, I think that's pretty much it. Thank you for watching, I suppose. Yeah, eventually I'll just probably like play this game. But for now, I'm probably gonna uninstall this to free up some space and possibly play the game whenever I feel like it. Okay, yeah, thank you for watching, and I think that's it for now.